Magandang lahat. Ako si Mark, ang host niyo for tonight. Welcome to Pinoy Crossover, where Filipinos are talking ball straight up. I'm excited for tonight because before the All-Star Weekend, this is our episode. Mm-hmm. And for our episode today, we have our special guest. Introduce yourself.
Hi, my name is Ingrid.
And JR, we're back today. How you feeling?
Good, good to be back. You know, special time in this season, right before the All-Star break. So great to talk more basketball.
I'm excited because we're going to talk more about it. But before we get started on that, let's talk about Ingrid. I want to know anything about you about basketball. What got you started into basketball?
I mean, if you're Filipino, I figure it's mandatory.
It's a civil duty.
It's a civil duty to either play ball or even to watch basketball. You got to do either one or the other. So that's what really got me into basketball. I mean, it's in our blood kind of thing. So that's why.
Did your parent or did your dad play basketball?
My dad did. Practically the majority of my family does, so a lot of my cousins do. They played for like college ball in the Philippines. I have a lot of cousins here that also play ball here, like for George Brown, Seneca, and all that stuff too. So yeah, and then for like the Filipino league as well.
How was it like playing during those Filipino leagues, and especially those younger ones too, where growing up and trying to, you know, implement trying to mimic what, you know, your other family members have been playing basketball?
See, I came there to always support. I wasn't really the one to play, yeah. Which is really funny. Yeah. I mean, the last time I probably picked up a basketball was like when I was 18 years old.
Oh my God.
Yeah, so it's been a while. So like that's how I know. I'm just watching ball instead of playing it, basically. Yeah.
What made you fall in love with the sport? Like, what's kind of thing that got you like to watch it more often or to actually keep watching it?
So crazy story behind that. I think it goes way back to the generations of like, you know, with Spud Webb,
yeah.
Probably the smallest player in like the NBA, probably kind of inspired me to play ball at one point and really get into the game kind of thing. So that's really what it was, especially that the fact that he was like, what, 5'4" and he could dunk.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
That was amazing.
That's amazing.
Everyone
so yeah.
Was just surprised
I'm just
by
like,
that.
I want to be just like him. I'm like, not really.
But you just wanted to be like
I just wanted to be like it. Just yeah. Like the fact that like small players can actually play in the big leagues kind of thing, right?
Yeah.
That given dream, whatever it was.
Did you used to watch like back in the day, which team did you used to watch? Or is it specifically Raptors already or
specifically Raptors. Back it was like, what, 1995 when they started the franchise? Mm-hmm. I didn't really understand it because I was really young. Mm-hmm. I think what really got me to really follow and love the Raptors and all of basketball was probably like back in 2001, you know, Philly and Toronto in the semifinals
that
and
was,
everything.
Oh
yeah, that was
God.
A crazy game. Yeah, you know, yeah. There was just like a head-to-head, like that whole matchup between like AI and Vince Carter and everything, and just that missed shot that we, you know, that broke everyone's heart.
Oh, yeah. My. To
it
win it?
My heart to this day.
He was open.
It does, but like that's what kind of like made me grow that love for ball, and especially for the Raptors. It's just that, like, we can make it that far no matter how bad it was, like despite that moment. So, yeah, that's what it was.
Did you have any other favorite players growing up other than, like, Spud Webb?
So, like, that was, like, way back in the generation. So, like, it just changes from time to time. So, like, from time of, like, Dominique Wilkins, yeah. You know, MJ and everything like that, too. You know, Kobe Bryant in our generation back then, but then he's retired now, but that's about it. Like, but overall, my favorite player back then would have to be like Vince Carter, Allen Iverson especially.
Yeah.
So yeah.
What about their game that kind of gets you like, oh my God, there's something about them that they do? Or is there a specific like swag in their game? Or
especially,
off,
yeah, that's especially when it comes to AI too. Like, come on, he calls himself the answer, yeah. You know, right? So like, it's just the fact that he throws it, like, you know, in all the interviews, you know, like his, you know, his well-known, interview where it's like practice.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yo, we're talking about practice, like that kind of stuff, you know?
The famous one.
There's the like controversy about that, why he talked about it, because the fact that you guys are, you know, he puts his heart out on the line when he plays, but then you guys are focusing on something with regards to practice that doesn't even really matter.
No.
Like where he puts his heart out on a game every single night, and then you call him out on something so little like practice.
Yeah.
And let alone with like even just the what he wore and everything too.
Mm-hmm.
When he was like he was like the one rocking cornrows and everything, sweatband and everything, armbands, like his whole swag and everything. Like he was just breaking barriers.
He was the first one to break barriers.
Like, yeah, he
but
was.
But like the
that's
players
why.
Nowadays, in terms of how they look like, do you think AI was the person that kind of inspired everyone to be able to, or that allowed them to be able
for
to?
For sure, hands down. He was probably the most influential one out of them
to
this generation going and moving forward and stuff like that. I mean, look at Russell Westbrook now, right?
Yeah.
And his swag and stuff too, right? So
I can see that.
Him and James Harden.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, especially Harden too, yeah.
Breaking the barriers, like, not like the casual, you know, wear a suit to a game.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Now you can wear anything. It doesn't have to be a suit. It could be like a full-on Nike Tech Fleece suit.
Yeah.
That's it.
I think no, you mostly see KD doing that, though.
Yeah.
So I'm just like, come on, man, really?
Yeah. So you mentioned us about your players that you've watched in the 90s. What about your favorite players that you've watched throughout the 2000s besides Vince Carter and AI? Any players stood out to you watching throughout the 2000s and then to the new 2010 till now era? Like, what have you noticed?
So obviously Kobe, within that generation as well. Like, I had I didn't really like him, but I respected him. Just the fact that he dropped.
I feel the same way with LeBron.
I respect him and the way that, because he has the game, like he knows it, like he knows how to play and everything. That's just the way it is. Like, especially with Kobe, like the fact that he dropped 81 points on us from way back. I hate
you. How did you feel about that?
I hated him, but I'm just like, dang, that's really cool that you can do that, right? It's not bad. Come on, 81 points though.
I don't think Jalen Rose was happy about that. I don't think he's still happy about
that.
No,
they had the interview about that too, like the recap of like how he felt and with that, with Jalen Rose and everything. Or that commercial that
there's
they did.
There's a full-on commercial about it.
Yeah.
He always mentioned that Kobe only scored 17 on him. He was like, only 17 points was scored on
him.
Or he got switched out. That's what I was like, yeah.
Yeah, you saw the commercial though, right? Yeah. So it's like, how many olives, Mr. Ryan? He's like, I'll have 81.
There's a long stare between them.
Oh my God.
You haven't seen it?
No, I haven't seen it.
Oh, you gotta watch it. It's so funny.
Oh, sure, yeah. See that now.
It's a good sneak diss with it.
Yeah. What about in the 2010 era till now? Like, which players have kind of gotten your attention or have kind of gotten your, liking in terms of the way they play or on and off the court?
On and off the court? I'm trying to think right now. Back in 2010. I can't really think off the top of my head, but like I just have to say, obviously, like love for DeMar DeRozan and everything from way back and everything, coming into the Raptors. Can you just say like what for later on? I guess
From 2000 till now, 2010 till now, like the kind of the most recent players that.
Oh yeah, yeah. Okay. So obviously Giannis Antetokounmpo, like that guy is ridiculous. He's a beast and everything too. So yeah, moving forward for this year's and everything, yeah. Well, for you guys.
I've been a fan of Steph Curry since he was drafted. Yeah, like the moment he was drafted, just watching them in his rookie year with Monte Ellis, I knew like they had to give up one or the other. Yeah. Thank God they kind of had faith in Steph, even though they had like the weakest kind of. I felt for him because one of the reasons why I was like, my ankle was really bad too. So I felt for him like God, like this player was good and like he just had bum ankles until like. That was fixed, so thank God they kind of had faith in him, as opposed to Monte, because Monte's out of the league and like Steph Curry's taking over the league.
I never really had a favorite player, I think.
Yeah, I didn't have one either back in 2010.
It's just, there's just like, I
from
think
here
now,
till now, like,
from
the,
here till
there's
now,
a new
yeah.
generation.
Yeah, that's what it is.
It's not
that
kind of the new generation, it's a lot of players I could pick from.
Yeah.
And I just like, I like the whole draft class, basically, or like a whole group of players that are playing right now. Nothing one that sticks out, other than maybe back then, Carmelo Anthony, but now he's just. Carmelo's he's not playing anymore. But.
There was a lot of players in the 2000s that kind of was fun to watch.
I think
Dirk was there, Kevin Garnett was like Tim Duncan's era, Kobe, Nash, like all these kind of players were fun to watch in the 2000s, right? And in the 2010, it's kind of where the three-pointer pace and space kind of game started taking over and then just a lot of shooting.
I just feel like this is a different generation when it comes to basketball now. Before it used to be so fundamental, now everyone's just like star players and everything and... You know?
It's a lot of, you have to be skilled in every single thing.
Like
passing, dribbling, handles, and shooting.
Yeah.
You have to be skilled now where back then you could be like a player that has certain roles, right? You can be a 3-and-D player and you're okay back then with Bruce Bowen. Or you can be a pass first point guard like Jason Kidd or Nash and it was fine. Mm-hmm. But now you have to be multiple things, like not just be able to shoot, be able to handle, be able to pass, be able to defend.
Yep.
Like, it's very different.